This is me, 10 meters underwater, trying to blow up a balloon. I say trying because I don't actually know if it's possible or not. So, can you blow up a balloon underwater? Well, before you pause the video and think about your answer, you need to know four things. Number one, I'm 10 meters underwater. Number two, I'm using normal scuba equipment. Number three, these are perfectly normal balloons. And number four, the water temperature is about 12 degrees C. I first started thinking about this question because I wanted to film the classic scuba experiment of taking a balloon and showing it increase and decrease in size as you go up and down in the water, as the pressure changes and therefore the volume changes. But I looked on the internet and I couldn't find a clear answer. It had very conflicting views, the internet, odd that. Some places said, no, there's no way you can blow it up underwater. The pressure underwater is too much to be able to inflate the balloon with your lungs. Other places said, no, it'll be fine. Go ahead, you can do that. And as a biologist, I know that no amount of theorizing can substitute for a practical experiment. And that's why we're here on a very cold and windy beach in the middle of Cornwall, messing around with balloons. And this is my friend Alex, who showed at least some interest in my balloon idea, is a much more experienced diver than me, and so I roped him in to help. Oh, and he wanted to be introduced as enjoying baking and extreme sports, so there you go. While the two of us were planning this dive, the whole experiment turned out to actually be a lot less straightforward and less safe than I had originally anticipated. Because the key to diving safely is to stay in control of your buoyancy at all times. That's why we wear jackets that we can inflate and deflate with air, and we wear lead, literal blocks of lead, on belts around our waist to counteract any extra buoyancy. Now, if we did manage to blow up the balloon underwater, seal it off, as we went up to the surface, it would expand in volume, as you would expect. But that means that the diver holding the balloon would also increase in buoyancy. Now, if only we happened to have some pressurized canisters of air just, you know, lying around on a random beach in Cornwall, we could test how much this balloon could increase in volume and therefore how much extra buoyancy we would have to compensate for in lead. And we guessed it was about 4 kilos of extra lead we'd need to wear. But if the balloon reached its maximum size and popped, then the diver holding it would suddenly start sinking. And unfortunately in scuba diving, there's a lot of positive feedback loops where you start to sink and so you become less buoyant and that makes you sink even faster. Now, we weren't exactly like diving over open ocean, so we weren't gonna go sinking into the abyss. But still, sudden pressure changes can be really painful. You can burst your eardrums, you can burst the blood vessels in your eyeballs and around on your face. I've done both of them, not comfortable. And overall, it's unpleasant. And so if the balloon were to pop, we would have to suddenly inflate our buoyancy jacket as much as possible, as fast as possible. You can see how this is a lot more dangerous than I had planned. But long story short, we sorted it out with all the lead and all the buoyancy. And finally, we just wanted to practice the act of blowing up a balloon underwater, because obviously we're breathing air through what's called a regulator. And that means that we have to take a breath, take the regulator out of our mouths before breathing into the balloon, and then putting the regulator in our mouth before taking our next breath in. Now, it's less scary than it sounds because yes, you do get water in your mouth when you open your mouth underwater, but you just breathe out before your next breath in, or there's a little purge button on the regulator that floods it with air. And so it's actually not that hard. It's one of the most basic skills you learn as a diver, taking your regulator in and out of your mouth for obvious reasons. I mean, maybe there's a shark underwater whose birthday party it is and you need to blow up a balloon to celebrate. Who knows? Okay, so now we'd worked out the logistics of how one might be able to blow up a balloon underwater, it was time to see if we could. Whether or not we should is a completely different matter entirely. Before we tested it, I asked some of the other divers in my group what their predictions were.
The air pressure in your lungs is the same as the water pressure outside, so it should be the same as on the surface.
I think that as you go down, your breathing pressure, The air from the cylinder is going to be pressurized at the same thing as the outside. So it'll be equal to what's going to be going on the outside.
I think partially.
Okay.
I think you can blow some air into it,
yeah.
But at a point, you reach a point where it's hard to provide the adequate power from the lungs to fully inflate it.
I think if you're at 10 meters, that the pressure is twice the ambient pressure.
Yeah.
I'm not sure that your lungs can provide twice the ambient pressure. They'd have to, I guess they'd have to shrink to like half their volume. Well, actually, maybe they can. I'm gonna stick to my guns. I'm gonna say no. At 10 meters, no. But at less than 10 meters, yes.
I don't think the depth will know. I think probably the most likely factor would be the density difference between the air and the water. The air would go upwards, right? So go into the balloon, so then it should inflate underwater, hopefully.
I think there's two things you need to work against when blowing up the balloon.
Yeah.
The ambient pressure of the air pushing it in.
Yeah.
And the elasticity of the balloon.
Yeah.
The elasticity I don't think should matter.
Okay.
In the water.
Yeah.
And the ambient pressure, because this is the whole point of scuba diving, you're breathing with higher pressure air.
Yeah.
Should also be the same pressure as the water outside.
Yeah.
So I think it should work exactly the same way as it ever does out here.
As you can see, they summarise the key points excellently, as one might expect from a bunch of scientists studying at Oxford. And after all that, here is my friend Alex trying to blow up a balloon underwater. So going through the clues I gave at the start, we're 10 metres underwater. Every 10 metres of water equates to an increase in pressure of 1 bar or 1 atmosphere. That means that at 10 metres underwater, the pressure is exactly double that at the surface. So one of the thoughts that I had initially was whether your diaphragm could physically push against that extra air, the extra pressure, because at higher pressure it will become more viscous. But seeing as the deepest scuba divers are able to breathe at over 300 meters, that's over 300 times atmospheric pressure, I don't think the biology of the muscles or the lungs are going to be a limiting factor here. Second, we're wearing normal scuba equipment. SCUBA, if you don't know, is an acronym for Self-Contained Underwater Breathing Apparatus. And it's designed so that air is stored at a really high pressure inside the cylinder, but is delivered to your mouth at exactly the same pressure as the surroundings. So at 10 meters, the pressure is twice atmospheric pressure, and so the air I'm breathing is also twice atmospheric pressure. Therefore, the pressure difference between the inside of my lungs and the surrounding water is the same as the pressure difference between my lungs and the air when I'm at the surface. So the absolute pressure is indeed higher underwater, but the relative pressure is the same as if I was at the surface. These are normal balloons. Now, one of the really counterintuitive things I struggled to get my head around is that the resistance you feel when you try to blow up a balloon isn't from trying to push the surrounding water or air out of the way, but is instead entirely from overcoming the elastic forces in the latex itself. We can breathe out forcefully using our muscles to push the air out of our lungs, but when we breathe out normally, we don't use any muscles to force the air out. It's just the elastic forces of our lungs and our ribs squeezing back into their normal shape. If the resistance you felt blowing up a balloon came from the surrounding air, that means that we'd be forcefully exhaling every single time we breathed out, which we don't. And importantly, the elasticity of the latex, this balloon resistance, will not change with depth, so it shouldn't be any harder the deeper you go. And as you can see, this categorically proves that it is possible to blow up a balloon underwater. Now, you may have noticed at this point that I have not shown you my attempt at trying to blow up a balloon underwater, and that's because it looked like this. This all ties into the final clue I gave at the start of the video, that the water is 12 degrees. Now, this would be chilly on land, but underwater, where water conducts heat away from your body 25 times faster than it does in air, it feels bloody freezing. And the way we avoid getting hypothermia underwater is actually just to stop the water from touching our bodies full stop using a dry suit. And unlike a wetsuit, it's airtight and we have thermal clothes underneath it to trap air against our bodies, not water against our bodies. But as you can see, our lips are still exposed to this cold water. And if you've ever tried speaking when your mouth is really, really cold, you'll know that you just lose all fine motor control over your lips. And so after all of the physics of pressure and all of the physics of elasticity and preparing for the dangers of sudden buoyancy changes, the actual bit that's hardest about blowing up a balloon underwater is just creating an airtight seal with the balloon And so instead of blowing up the balloon, I kind of blew bubbles in the general direction of the balloon. Oh, and the mask I'm wearing creates a seal against your upper lip. And that means that when you change the shape of your lips, for example, when you're trying to blow a balloon, it breaks the seal and water starts flooding in, which is why I had to stop to clear my mask every single time I took a breath. So that solves it. It is possible to blow up a balloon underwater, but that doesn't mean that everybody can. And after all that, the experiment I was initially looking for of showing the volume change of the balloon as we go up and down in the water was really underwhelming on camera at such a shallow depth. But at least when we popped the balloon, it made pretty cool bubble rings. So that was nice, I suppose. This is the first of three scuba diving videos that I've already filmed for this channel. But I'm hopefully going to be doing more scuba diving this summer as I finally passed my sports diver exam. Woohoo! So if you do have any weird and wacky things you think might be cool to film underwater in the UK, let me know.
The one I that blew up was so positively buoyant.
Pardon?
The one I blew up was so positively buoyant.
Yeah.
I was like grabbing it with both hands and pushing it down as I could.
Who you got yours at? It's obviously physically possible. It requires a level of skill that I've got.
Your tiny balloon on the.
It's just like, yeah, that's physics for you. Physics says you can blow up a tiny balloon underwater, bring it to the surface, and it's all going to be great.
Do you want to go back?
Yeah, let's go back.